Did you ever install Windows? If you did, some of you might have faced a problem. Windows can't be installed in this drive, since the drive is MBR or /GPT. This is a common problem. So, let's fix it. Hey, what is up guys? Welcome to XT. And you get this error about GPT and MBR. Many of you ends up formatting the entire HDD instead of one system partition. So before you install a fresh Windows in your PC, you need to know some basic things about your PC. Something like, is your PC running in legacy BIOS or UEFI BIOS? Ringing bells? You have heard about it. BIOS. You might have seen it somewhere, maybe on your startup screen. Something like, press F12 for BIOS. Well, different computers has different shortcuts to access the BIOS setup. So what does it actually mean? BIOS, Basic Input Output System, aka motherboard's firmware. The BIOS is a code that sits on the flash memory of your motherboard, and it links the software to the hardware. So the BIOS does some very basic things, but those are very important things, and most essential. And without it, you would never be able to watch AXT videos, or you could never get snacks while you play COD, maybe. I mean you get that, right? I mean, you could never be able to turn up your PC. So when you turn up your PC, the first thing that will sprinkle up is the BIOS. It checks your settings, how you want to run your PC, and then initializes the peripheral like CPU, RAM, graphics card. And after that, BIOS will run the power on self test to make sure everything is functioning correctly. And once that's done, the BIOS will search for a bootable device. Means some kind of drive which has OS installed in it. After that, OS will boot up and then OS will take care of the rest of the things. Now, the old BIOS system provided a link between keyboard, mouse and other devices and the OS. Well, nowadays, the modern operating system takes care of everything. So once your OS is loaded, your BIOS goes to sleep until the next time you turn on your PC. So BIOS is cool, right? And if you think that, then my friend, you are wrong. Legacy BIOS has serious limitations. One of the most obvious issue is the drive support. A system that a legacy BIOS uses to access your HDD or SSD is the master boot record or MBR file system. MBR can handle only up to 2 TB of storage and maximum of 4 primary partitions. Such a limitation. Well, that was fine for a long time. But now, with the modern HDD holding way more storage, it's hard to live with it. This is 2018 and 8K videos are already here. And sooner than you think, 4K is going to be the next standard quality of a video. And these new advanced games are over 70 to 80 gigs. So it became obvious to bring some new technology in the line. And it's the Unified Extensible Firmware Interface, or UEFI. Not only UEFI can handle insanely large amount of drive. Hey, we're talking about millions of petabytes. But also it boots up real quick and can use actual graphics interface completely with animations and mouse support. So UEFI uses the GPT system to access your HDD or SSD. And in case you are wondering, GPT stands for GUID partition table and GUID stands for global unique identifier. GPT can easily handle more than 2 TB of hard disk size. To be exact, it supports up to 7 to 8 zettabyte hard disk.
Holy moly.
Holy moly, that's insane. Cause that's not even out yet. And can you imagine, GPT can handle a HDD of zettabyte. Well, it will take several years to invent a HDD with a 1 zettabyte size. If you don't know what zettabyte is, you can check this. Also, you can make 128 primary partitions in a GPT drive. So, legacy BIOS uses MBR file system and UEFI uses GPT file system. Usually, to switch between these two file system, MBR and GPT, you need to format your entire hard disk. I mean, you will have to delete all the partitions and all the files that you have stored. Obviously, you don't want to lose your files. So, just say, I use a hard disk which has MBR file system and I don't want to lose the files except the C drive partition. That's where actually the Windows gets installed. Since it's MBR, so you know that you need to boot it in the legacy BIOS mode. And before you do that, you need to make your flash drive bootable. You can use this software called Rufus. I'll leave the links in the description for this. So, in Rufus, you need to select your USB drive, and in the partition scheme, in my case, I need to select the first one, because my hard disk file system is MBR. Also, my motherboard has both of the legacy BIOS and UEFI BIOS. In case you don't have UEFI, but only the BIOS, don't worry. Rufus will detect and give you the options. So after that, select the ISO file and click start. When everything is hunky-dory, insert the flash drive and turn up your boot menu. And you need to select your flash drive. And in my case, I need to select the legacy BIOS mode, not the UEFI. Once you do that, Windows will never give you that error. So guys, that's it. If you think this video helped you, make sure you hit that like button. And you know what? Just subscribe to my channel. And also share this video with your friends. And if you think this video sucked, you know what to do. Until then, see you guys in the next one.